Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophiness and welcome back to The Witcher 3 on the Deathmarch difficulty. We're still playing the Heart of Stone DLC, and we're just outside the Von Everack Crypt, and we're gonna head towards the wedding, but first I'm gonna check out Shani's, description in the glossary and check out if we can't find out anything more about her. So, there was another bit added. Geralt's encounter with Vladimir von Everack reminded him that he and Shani had once shared passionate, though passing, feelings for each other. He also became aware some remnant of these feelings was still lodged in his heart. So that indicates that we might be able to start a little something with Shani in the future. But we'll meet Shani by the farm, where the wedding will be held in a minute. So see you guys there.
I remember that mill. Whenever Olgierd and I got up to mischief, we'd hide out in there.
Hello,
once,
Vladimir.
Snuck off with some moonshine. Old cocksucker Yaramir caught us. those were the days.
Apparently they were. So yeah, Vladimir has been appearing once every while now to pitch in a little bit. But I'm gonna head to the wedding right now. Just added this so you guys could see what happened. So see you guys in a second. Or not.
Geralt, old chap. Mind turning your ass around and going back to the wedding? I was to have a bit of fun, not a bloody walkabout. Keep this up, and I'll get sore legs is all. Not quite what Olgierd asked for.
Fine, we'll go back.
Okay then. I wanted to use the fast travel point to go closer to the wedding, but apparently it's pretty close by, so we need to walk over there. So I think we're getting pretty close to the farmhouse where we need to meet... Yeah, there we go. Where we need to meet Shani.
No sign of her yet. We need to wait.
Okay. I wonder what Vladimir is up to. As he must have a plan of some sort to,
This is very romantic.
Fuck off.
Yeah, indeed. Fuck off, Vladimir.
Behold! Wars have started over uglier wenches. Well, raids have been undertaken at least.
True. She looks lovely. Let's go.
Whoa, whoa, hold! You mean to go in? Wearing that.
What else?
Have you seen how she's dressed? I'll not parade at that jewel's side in a rank tunic. You need a robe. One daren't attend a wedding in anything less.
Okay,
then. I happen to have a robe handy.
What do you mean? What about that?
What about what? Oh, God. Not about to steal, Yandy.
Oh, no, we're not gonna steal.
Come now, we're merely borrowing.
Oh, crap, there we go again. the way he walks. Wonderful. This looks weird.
Perfect fit. It feels tailor-made.
Maybe get out now?
For shoes. One must wear shoes to a wedding.
Not boots. Well, I have shoes in my inventory. Oh no.
And we must be neat.
Okay then. I was afraid he was going to cut our boots, but look at that.
May they draw and quarter me if I've ever seen a lovelier lass.
Nothing left of you to draw and quarter, alas.
Doe eyes, a swan's soft, supple neck, and a waist so slim you could grip it one-handed.
You're actually quite amusing this way.
Look at that, she's looking fine as well. Okay, we must get to know each other better, or you see, Geralt can't hold a candle to me. Let's go with the first one.
Be assured, you'll like me even better when you come to know me more intimately.
How intimately?
Enough to get a sense of my assets, my dear. Trust me, they're nothing to scoff at.
May I please speak to Geralt for a moment?
Whatever for. This evening is about my pleasure, not his.
Just for a moment, then you can jump right back in.
Oh, he's insulted.
Be quick. I'll not stand here doing naught. I'm to enjoy myself.
Geralt, I'm about to introduce you to the newlyweds. Please make sure your friend doesn't embarrass me.
I can't make him do anything. All that nonsense is his. I feel like an ass saying it.
I like some of that nonsense.
Yeah, I thought so. For example?
What, for example?
It would do you good to be more relaxed sometimes.
Relaxed? So you think I'm uptight?
What I mean is, it would be nice from time to time if you could sit back and enjoy life, instead of going around solving everyone's problems.
But what does... I don't understand.
Of course you don't. You're as dense as year-old hardtack. Luckily, you've got me.
Okay, sounds like some sort of plan. And I don't know where this is going, but let's go to this wedding
then.
We'll
talk later. Let's go to this wedding. The sooner the ghost has his fun, the sooner this'll be over.
Finally, something that's not utter tripe. We shall dance till the break of dawn.
You get till midnight and not a second longer.
That's not enough. I shan't even get properly soused by midnight, let alone...
Make an effort. I'm sure you'll manage. You get to frolic and carouse till midnight. That's our deal. Then there's the capping. Then you go back where you came from.
So be it.
Yeah, take what you can get, Vladimir. And there's that pose again.
My strawberry.
She kind of looks like one, actually. Here we go.
Hello, world. I'm back.
This is some other sort of mission, isn't it?
Damned. A proper wedding. Overladen tables, plenty of worthy drinking companions, and a swarm of fair maids.
Yes, indeed. But the loveliest is at your side, I think.
But none compared to
there we
you,
go.
My dear Rhubarb.
I think she's gonna be called every kind of vegetable and
by the size
fruit.
Of its house, the mutt must be big as a horse.
Thanks for your concern, but the doghouse is empty.
They let a man-eater like that run free? Have the wedding guests been warned? Seems we are indeed in for a cracking good time.
Okay. This is very interesting. It's not the kind of scene we've been
lovely Rowan.
Coming across.
I remember making necklaces of the fruit when I was a child.
Ah, the berries make for splendid hooch. Olgird and I brew it in our teething years.
So she likes Rowan berries?
I should introduce now. Try to behave.
We'll do our best.
Rowan battle, I'd do anything.
Okay, follow Shani and meet the newlyweds. Well, I suppose,
come. Time to meet and...
And what?
Time to say hello. Be nice now.
Hello.
Once more, all the best in your new life.
Thank you.
It's us now. Dearies, blessings rain down upon you.
May you live in health and happiness. Harmony and love forever last betwixt you.
Thank you, from the bottom of our hearts.
Now go, enjoy the feast.
Our turn.
Okay, yes indeed, our turn. Oh God.
My dear friend Aldona and her chosen one, Jonas.
Aldona and Jonas.
The sun shine brightly on this new path in your lives. I am Vlo.
This is my friend of yesteryear, Geralt of Rivia.
Yes. Tis I, Geralt, a witcher. Heartfelt thanks for your hospitality. I adore weddings. The bride's especially.
Shut up. Shut up.
Righto. I'm sure we'll all have a splendid time.
Why'd you choose this chap? You get a hefty dowry with your bride, and how do you know Shani? That's maybe a more interesting question.
Tell me, Aldona. How is it you and my dear Shani know each other?
We met in Oxenfurt. Both studied medicine at the academy.
Wondrous times.
Over quickly in my case, alas. My family couldn't afford to keep me there. I was forced to return home after 1 year.
It's never too late
to pursue an education, my dear. Your husband is certain to help you complete your studies, provide the necessary coin.
I don't know. We've not talked about it.
Come, Jonas, surely you've not taken Aldona as a mere diversion for the alcove. You will help her, will you not?
That is between me and her. You needn't butt in.
But I'm not. Okay. I merely ask. See, I've come to love your wife like a sister. So I ask you, as your brother-in-law, will you help her?
I'm sure we'll discuss the matter.
That's my lad. You're a right decent chap. I knew it from the start.
I don't think he sees it that way, but I think the two other subjects are a bit more, not good to have a bit of a talk about that. So let the revels begin.
We've chewed the fat enough. Time's a-wasting.
Are you expected elsewhere?
Me? Ha! I simply cannot wait to sample your liquors and dance with the local matrons.
Jonas and I invited more than a few lovely maidens. Perhaps one of them will catch your eye.
Oh, don't indulge his...
Certain.
And perhaps you will catch one of their...
It'd be nice, certainly, but I shan't be terribly bothered if it's not the case. Come, let's drink.
Okay. Don't really know what that was all about, but... Maybe I'm as much a doofus as Geralt is. Take part in the wedding activities until midnight. Okay. So we can do several things located on the map.
So if he arrived, why is he not here now?
What's this?
Ooh.
Okay. Oh, here, drink.
Drink with us!
I never say no to a lady. To your fair beauty. And to your shiny, naturally.
Your elf and happiness.
Fortune smile upon you, white wolf.
Thank you. Can I talk to Shani, actually?
The capping starts at midnight. Until then, enjoy yourself. Well, go wild.
Okay. What else is there? There's something up here as well. Hello.
Of all these flowers, you, my dear, are the loveliest.
Believe the young man's mistaken me for another.
Yeah, I think he has.
I like my women as I like my peaches. Fuzzy and well ripe.
That's enough. Get going. You drunken Randy. Nothing good's ever come
of this. Okay, then. Look at this place. It's right bustling. Okay, let's drink with these guys.
Sir Dwarves, may your beards grow long but never tangle round your ankles.
To the young lovers, may their loins never cough. May they sire many a bear and make gods a coin.
Yes, indeed. Can I dance? I want to see Geralt dance. Hello. There we go, look at him go.
I'd show you how I cut a jig, nimble as a leopard.
Don't let me stop you.
She's dancing as well, look at that. I think this is the wildest we've seen Geralt act. Though it's not really Geralt, so let's stop with that.
What charm, what grace.
Thanks.
And the compliments are flying all around, let's see what else we can do. So there was this couple.
Do you need help?
Shani, darling. Oh, you shan't believe what's happened. I'm marrying off my only daughter. Wanted a proper wedding for her. Wild revelry. So I hired a true fire eater. You know, whoosh, gulp, sizzle, sizzle.
Ooh, I've not seen that sort of trickery.
Horribly dear. Diversions of that sort. He journeyed here from Novigrad.
But I'll not squeeze coppers on my daughter, oh no. The groom's family have us for paupers. But we'll show them how wrong they are.
Seems we won't, in fact, for our fire swallowers has gone as last Yule's pudding.
Groom's hound chased him off. That blasted demon. Ugh, they sure named it right.
Oh, so that's where the dog went.
Dublin. Master Witch is here now. Perhaps he can aid us.
Tell me everything you know.
Before I can begin my witcherly investigation, I require guidance, clues. Tell me all you know, everything.
Well, the Fire Eater arrived around noon, ate his fill of food, not fire, and went for a stroll to air some gases, he said. That horrid demon saw him and started barking like a thing possessed.
Why so?
Haven't a clue. Didn't like the man, sent something awry. Perhaps that the man swallowed fire. Animals fear fire.
If I feared, it would have fled, not given chase.
Damn fool dog. How can you know? But it snapped its chain and chased the Fire Eater into the woods.
Foolish or not, it's our son-in-law's beloved pet. There'll be hell to pay if it goes missing.
So we've got two problems here. We need to find the Fire Eater and we need to find the dog as well. Both preferably alive, so we shall find him.
You needn't worry. The Witcher, that is, I, will find this swallower of heated things.
Mighty generous offer, but no one knows where to look.
We can follow the dog prints, probably.
Witchers, that is, we have our ways. The Flame Gulper, what did he look like?
He wore a jester's cap. Typical sort. Ought to be enough to identify him.
I shall find him.
We thank you, and hope for the best.
Okay, so that's a tiny little side quest.
Awfully nice of you to offer your help, but are you sure you're up to it? You're not actually a witcher, Vladimir.
I wish to find this magician. Give it a go, all right? But you cannot help me. I must do it alone. I expect it will be great fun.
Okay, so that's interesting.
Fine. Don't have to do this, but if I were you, I'd find the dog's tracks, follow its trail. Just a thought.
Excellent advice. I'll take it.
And there he goes again.
To find the Fire Eater. If we're not back by midnight, then...
Relax. He'll be back in no time. I believe him.
Thank you, Shani.
Tally-ho. Adventure awaits.
I think she's enjoying herself a little bit too much with Vladimir. I think if Geralt stands still, he even takes that pose. God damn it. Look at that. So, use your witcher senses to find the Fire Swallower. So here are the dog prints.
A dog made these tracks, true, but a small one. And judging by its house, Demon is a hulk, but beggars can't choose their tracks. So I shall follow these.
I can check out everything else as well.
A bone not so clean, I've only ever seen two like this. One in an anthill, the other when I caught a hen after not eating for a week. Its bowl is chipped. Tried to devour its bowl along with its supper. Daft mutt.
So that indicates that the dog is in fact
down
bigger.
Towards chain off the wall. Underfed it seems. Or else the ash liquor really boiled the mutt's blood.
So... with that information, it seems weird that the tiny paw prints would be the prints of the dog.
Following some dog's trail? Not exactly how I imagined this wedding. Think I'll wait here.
Wonderful, okay. My juicy pear. I shall continue my travails while you rest. Shan't be long now.
No, it won't. So let's see. He went through this field. And what happened here?
A broken branch. As if one too heavy sought to scamper up this tree. Seems our Fire Eater swallows a great deal more than fire. Or perhaps someone was merely gathering kindling. Ah, there is joy in this ferreting.
There's a noise over there, and I'm gonna follow it. It seems to be up in a tree. There he is.
Is there anyone in this forsaken hole? Anyone at all?
Yeah, we are. We are. Take it easy. And I think it's gonna be a tiny dog, isn't it? Oh, look at that. Look at that.
Missing man, missing mutt.
Am I seeing this right? That gammy puss ran up a tree to escape that puppy.
I wonder... how did it break free then?
You, get down.
Oh no, no bloody chance. I value my life.
You swallow fire as a profession, but you're scared of a dog. I'll calm it.
Sit.
There we go. Axie saves the gate. So saves the day again.
If I'd had that, the Horsons never would have gutted me. Make it do some folly. Roll about on the ground. That sort of sport.
No.
Oh, could you be any more of a bore? I'll do it myself.
Well, it's already under the effect of Axie, so he probably will listen.
Roll over.
Hey, there he goes.
Were I to command it to eat its own tail, it would do so, right?
Demon, doghouse now.
Now what have you done? Why ever? Ruin my fun.
Have it at the wedding.
Yeah, because we... You would want to
Calm
have
down.
The dog alive,
the
right?
It's gone, as you can see.
You sure it won't return?
Positive.
Is he drunk?
Better safe than sorry, I always say.
Geralt, this jester is drunk as a skunk. I hope he's not polished off that bottle yet.
And there he goes again.
I saved your life, man. Do you not at least owe me a sip?
Course. Bottoms up.
There we go. Thanks, man. I think that was the entire bottle.
Mead. Now I understand why you wanted some private time with it.
Fine mead, true. But I was fleeing an hound. Hound? But it was a monster. A furry, faggy devil. They chose a fitting name for it.
Hmm. Are you always so easily scared?
You're a man whose trade is literally to play with fire.
There we go.
A tiny run of a
My argument
was
exactly.
A monster! A demon!
So you said. You're a stoneless coward, sir. That's that.
Oh, beg your pardon. I'm not a coward. I'm cautious. Know what become of a fire eater who paid no heed to caution?
I suppose he might singe his tongue.
Guessed it. Settles that misunderstanding.
And his face looks like he had a few accidents already.
You can forget about performing in your state.
And just what state would that be?
Look at drunk. Yourself, man. You're a tramp. Can barely stand.
Really, really drunk. Perform.
First off, that's bollocks. Second, I'm a fire eater, not a stilt walker. Standing straight ain't a requirement.
Hmm. Okay, what's the trick?
This may be my only
chance
to
fire eating.
Your fire guzzling trickery. How does it work?
Oh, they tossed me out the guild if I told. Except if I took you on as an apprentice. In half a year's time, you'd learn.
I haven't half a year. Come, just between you and me. We've drunk together. We're practically brothers.
Drank it all yourself. You're no brother of mine.
You dare toy with me this way? Very well. Refuse to tell me, and I shall leave you here as a morsel for any passing boars, bears, or bloodthirsty fawns.
Oh, stop so threatening the man.
This here's a soul. He's suppressing the arts.
Out with it.
I got a special mixture I drink before every show. After that, I can eat fire, spit fire, do what I please. It don't burn nothing.
Is that all? Where's the art in it? Any dribbling imbecile can smear his throat with a protective slurry.
Oh, but just about enough of this. First they release the hounds, then come and steal my mead, and now insults. I'm done here. Goodbye.
That's not a good idea.
End the bloody charlatan. Do something.
I'm not going anywhere.
Now, you're gonna forget everything you've seen, said, and heard in the woods.
Wouldn't a smack upside the head help the matter? Put the cheating coward back in his place.
No need. You'll go back to the wedding and show everybody your tricks.
Oh, your charlatan's tricks.
Vladimir is disappointed in you.
As you say.
Coming or not?
I'm coming. I'm coming.
To the wedding, then. Perhaps I'll find some more interesting diversions there.
Maybe you will. Indeed. Oh, keep now calm. We need to escort the fire swallowers. Jesus.
Wild animals behind every stump in these woods.
Okay. So I'm gonna suppose he's gonna get attacked, otherwise it wouldn't be a health bar.
Bear,
that. As much as your cock's a tentacle. I blind fool.
What the What the fuck is going on? Holy shit, that thing is pretty strong. Wild boars, that's new. Thank you.
Tell me, are bears often boar-shaped in your experience?
Got weak eyes, see? Besides, I'm a fire eater, not some damn naturalist.
Indeed, so yeah, you are not
boar,
master.
Bear, something completely different.
I fail to ask. What do they call you?
David Hattonsborough.
Listen here, Master Hattonsborough. Stay close and no harm will come to you. I'll see to it your drunken, fire-spitting gob gets to the wedding safe and sound. The missing fire blower is...
And apparently that was that, and nothing ever happened again.
It was
clearly
my doing, if I may say so myself.
And Demon? What's with him?
He failed to return.
No, he did. He's just acting mighty strange.
He's very friendly.
Seems to be in a muddle of sorts. Got as much life in him as a carrot.
Might have eaten some nightshade or whatnot.
Your attention, please! I invite all to witness a spectacle unrivaled. A man so bold as to eat fire!
I hope for this will
we
go
must
well.
Watch the trickery. Never saw anything like it while alive.
Oh, God. Be careful. I hope he drank his concoction. Oh god. Please work out. Okay, do it already. Oh, Shawnee. I feel like Shawnee is a bit in the same... Whoa, I never actually saw that, but the icon in the top left also changed.
Found his ass saved. If I could live again, I'd be a witcher for damn certain.
He has a shield with a boar on top of it, so that's probably the Von Everick sign. And well, I have a feeling that Shawnee is in the same position that Triss always has been. Yearning for Geralt but not getting any attention. Well, not the attention she wants. So let's see, there's halflings here as well.
Munchkins playing cards.
Munchkins playing cards, yeah. Yeah, Vladimir, Munchkins.
Perhaps you care to sit down to some Gwent with us?
Most certainly would. You needn't ask twice, midget.
No need for insults.
I tell it like it is, or apologies.
I'm sorry. I meant no offense.
Were that true, you wouldn't have called him a midget.
I've apologized. What else would you have me do? Bring him flowers?
I'd have you play and stop talking.
Let us play, gentlefolk.
What's your wager?
Everything. The whole lot. I'm all in.
Wait, what?
I never knew you to be such a gambler.
You shall see many new sides of me this night, my dear. Many large sides.
Oh, God. She might actually like that, by the way, but...
Normally we play that the loser's got to wear the ass ears.
I needn't care. I shan't lose.
Okay, then. It's been a while, but, here we go, I suppose. So I'll speed it up as I do, I usually do that with, forced Gwent games. Let's see here.
Clear. Well, let's remove that one. That looks great. Maybe swap out the clear weather card for something else. Yeah. Looking mighty fine. Okay, so that's, support class. I'll go with, my triple multiplier here. My scout, I think. Ooh, thanks for that. Oh shit, that's painful. That's really painful. Okay. So he can do the same thing probably. Left stand points added with a hero card. And it appears he's copying me. That's pretty weird. I can gonna use this now, and then revive one of those two dudes. There we go. Unless he has another Scorch card, of course. The opponent has passed, so I don't even need to use my commander's horn. So, because we won this round. There we go. And I get an extra card. There goes Siri. Let's put Siri on the board immediately. 15 points. Okay. So let's start putting up my catapults, my siege weapons. A commander's horn. That was to be expected. Let's put another siege weapon over there. Oh god, this is pretty bad. Maybe I should... Wait. And use the commander's horn. Boost that, and then see what he does. This won't do much. And then I'm gonna have to pass if I want to win this round. Well, the next one. There we go. And he gets another card. Ooh, shit. I might actually lose this one. So I can do 12 and multiply that, but that's... It's far from a win, because he's already over that. Fuck. Okay, well that didn't work out. And I'm done. Damn, I haven't lost a game in a while. Didn't have the best hand to start with.
Wow.
You lose, Witcher. Hand over the wager. Everything.
Perhaps we could reach an arrangement?
No weaseling out of this. Hand over the coin!
What do we do now?
Feel good, losing somebody else's coin?
I meant to win, give you the coin. I've no need for it in the grave.
But you lost, so now I've got to pay up.
I say, he talking to himself? Roaring drunk already, that's it.
We can't fleece a drunk. Have him don the cup and we'll call it even.
Just oh, that sounds great.
Bloke needs a lesson. I say he dons the cap and gives us 5% of the coin he has.
Ooh, that's a lot.
Agreed. 5% is yours, and I shall wear the cap. Never fear.
That's a lot of money.
A man must do what a man must do, and Vladimir von Evereck's a man among men.
Hear that? So sloshed he thinks he's Vladimir von Evereck.
Rogue's long dead by my reckoning.
Exactly. Yes, indeed he is.
Those ears. You look, interesting.
Time to
and you
drink.
Sound drunk.
We are at a wedding.
Yes, indeed.
Let's drink. My time's as short as you are, friends.
To the Witcher and his betrothed.
Hear that, Shani? My betrothed. Know what that means?
No. What?
It means we should act as befits the betrothed.
And what's that mean?
He's gonna kiss you.
You resist. But it all ends as everyone knows it must. Ah, the merriment. Good show indeed. Let's continue the ball.